Welcome back to spreadsheetpoint.com. In this brief video, I will show you how to make a P&L or a profit and loss statement from scratch directly in Excel. So to start with, there are going to be some common rows that are included in a P&L statement. Some companies may have P&Ls that are more complex than others, but these are the main rows that you're going to be having in a P&L statement. Your income, which gives you the gross revenue, the cost of goods sold, and then that gives you a gross profit, and then the expenses, and then the net profit. The P&L normally has the months across the top, so let's just do that quickly here. And then cool feature with Excel is if you put in the month, you can just drag the cell over and it puts in the full month. Same thing if I want to spell it out. Let's just spell it out just like that. Okay, and we'll make these columns a little bit bigger, like so. Now, I think it's a good idea to have multiple rows for all of these items, just in case you need to add more than one income type. Perhaps we can name these products, actually. Product one, two, and three, just like so. Okay, and then these are going to be, so let's just put five, just put some amounts here, zero in October, and we're going to make the center just to make it easily a bit more readable. We'll bring these down just like so. And we can change these numbers, of course. So now you're going to add your sum formula and you can see the gross revenue for these items here. Okay. Let's make these actually a bit bigger than numbers. So let's just put 500 to keep it simple here. And we're going to change these numbers all to currency. Two decimal places, sure. Just like so. Okay. Maybe you want the gross revenue bolded, like so. Costs of goods sold section. Maybe there's packaging. Maybe there's shipping, like so. Okay. So maybe that's, I don't know, 100 a month and shipping, so let's say 50. These are complete examples, though. Obviously, your numbers are going to be a lot different than this. And then you're going to add the sum formula, add those values up. So now we have gross revenue, we have total cost. Now we can calculate gross profit. So that's going to be the revenue minus the cost, like so. Bring that formula over. And then the operating expenses. So let's make a couple rows for operating expenses. Let's do salary, office equipment, let's say. You're going to want to add a bunch of rows if depending on how you need them. Let's just put this 60 and then just put 40. Obviously, the salaries are going to be a lot more than that. This is just an example to show you how easy it is to build something like this. Maybe we want to add a total column as well here. And then you use the sum formula, drag this over just like that. We can add up all of those just to see what the year looks like. Maybe we make those bold too. Okay, so now we have a total expenses. Let's sum the expenses like so. And we will use the format painter to keep these bold. Now we can calculate our net profit or loss. Let's see. So we're going to take the gross profit minus the total expenses, and then we get a net profit, just like that. Okay. And this, it will be the sum of that. Okay. Let's say there was a big expense this month. Let's put $600. Let's put $1,500. Just to show you the loss. And then, of course, you can add maybe some conditional formatting if you want to highlight the negatives. Let's do new rule. Let's do highlight less than zero, like so. And then you can see the negative. Obviously, this can be formatted any way you want. Maybe you want to take the grid lines out. You know, maybe you want to have this top part a different color, like so. Maybe you want to add in some borders to the cells, more borders. Maybe you want to do something like that. This is fully customizable, however you would want to set it up, but it just gives you an idea of how relatively easy it is to set up a P&L in Excel. My favorite way though is to use a template. So let's go to File, New, look at these templates. Let's put in profit and loss. Look at all this. So if you don't want to build them from scratch, you can just use Excel's template feature. Here's one right here. Let's use this one. Create, and then bam. Basically, it's done all the work for you here. Okay, so same thing. You have the revenue, cost of goods sold or sales, and then your expenses. And way down at the bottom, there's profit. This model has taxes included as well. I hope you found this video useful. For more tips and tricks, please visit spreadsheetpoint.com and don't forget to like and subscribe.